So as you know, there is a lot of film cameras, and at first it's very daunting. You know, what camera do you choose? There's SLRs, there's compacts, there's TLRs, there's medium format, there's 35mm, there's a whole selection. And at first you don't really know, you just want to take a roll of film and take pictures because you've seen or heard other people do it, or you might have done it in the past and just forgotten how this all works. Some people just jump in and buy super high-end gear to begin with. And I would really suggest going against that because that's not really what film's all about. It's more about just enjoying the experience, taking your time, getting comfortable with the camera, you know, having a camera that speaks to you and you speak to it. You know, it's one that it becomes part of your personality, as cheesy as it sounds. And one of the cameras that I would say best hits the spot for starting is the Canon AE-1. And if you're into film photography, you have most likely heard of that camera. So as you can probably tell by the look of this thing started production a very long time ago. It was the year 1976 and the SLR war was well underway. All the legends of the time were in the ring fighting against each other. You had the likes of Leica, Nikon, Minolta, Olympus, and so many others. It was a great time for cameras as everyone was trying to flex their guns as hard as possible, compete against each other, and trying to win over the consumer. So it meant you had tons of selection of cameras, tons of lenses, new technologies, and a new technology that came with the Canon AE-1 was the microchip. So this is actually the world's first camera with a microchip inside. It helped with the exposure and with the shutter speed of the camera. So one of the things that makes the Canon AE-1 so attractive nowadays is that it houses the FD lens mount. So if you don't know about the FD lens series, they're highly regarded for being really durable, nice little bits of glass. Alongside that reputation is the price as well. These things you can pick up for super cheap. So you can pick up a 50mm 1.8 lens along with a Canon AE-1 for less than £90 if you know where you're looking that is. Shyness is nice and shyness can stop you from doing all the things in life you'd like to. Shyness is nice and shyness can stop you from doing all the things in life you'd like to. So if there's something you'd like to try, if there's something you'd like to try, ask me, I won't say no, how could I? Coyness is nice and coyness can stop you from doing all the things in life you'd like to. So if there's something you'd like to try, if there's something you'd like to try, ask me, I won't say no, how could I? So as you can probably tell from these pictures, I absolutely love this camera. This was actually my first ever 35mm camera. My journey with it only started the start of this year, and it's honestly been amazing. It's taught me everything I know about manual settings on a camera, you know, like things from aperture, shutter speed, just like everything, all the information you need to know about how to manually shoot photos, this thing has taught me. And it took some time, you know, to get more comfortable with the camera, figure it out, but as you can see, you get some really like beautiful images. You can't recreate images like that in digital, in my opinion, and the 50mm 1.4 lens I've got is a stunner. Film really just helped me understand composition more and just patience with shooting, because I was so used to digital. I had a Nikon D3300 before, and I was so used to just snap. And I never really just took the time, waited for a shot, or just saved shots until I really felt that I wanted to take them. So this has taught me a whole new form of photography, and it will forever be the purest form of photography for me. In the future, I just really hope to be able to start developing my own film, you know, when I have the time and money to do so. I just want to read some books on it, get the chemicals, get the kit, you know, like the whole gear, and just develop my own film and scan them, because I feel like I'm missing out a huge section still. But that's what's exciting about it, is there's still more to come and more to figure out. If you've watched to this point, I really thank you for watching this. I hope you enjoyed the content. If you've got any questions or just want to chat about film photography or anything, just leave a message in the comments. I'll definitely respond to you. And yeah, go out shooting and just have fun with it, guys.